Missouri Governor Jay Nixon said today there have been more than a dozen cases where the public wasn't told of high bacteria levels in the Lake of the Ozarks. KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum spoke to the governor today about the steps he's now taking.
The fallout is certainly being felt for the E. coli report that was withheld this past spring. Suspensions, investigations, and now former DNR Deputy Joe Benbutel has been fired.
Joseph was an able servant and a great leader for many years. I mean, he just didn't release the information, so I today, among other actions, pulled his appointment to the Administrative Hearing Commission.
Governor Jay Nixon said an internal investigation revealed systemic issues of underreporting E. coli contamination in the Lake of the Ozarks, finding 10 cases over the past 3 years where lake beaches weren't closed despite high levels. And the governor said there have been 14 cases since 2005 where the DNR did not tell the public about high bacteria levels.
Clearly, when you have 8, 10, 12 significant sewer spills that are announced publicly and no one is held accountable for that over the last 3, 4, and 5 years, it begins to develop a mentality of not being open and transparent with information.
It's a long-standing problem, according to Ken Mitgift with the Clean Water Campaign.
Now that there's been this major flap, that there will be some course changes. But up to this point, citizens have been placed at risk without knowing that they've been placed at risk.
Now the attention is squarely focused on the risk. In Kansas City, Dan Weinbaum, KMBC 9 News.
Currently, the Missouri State Senate is holding its own investigation into the E. coli flap. And following a 2-week unpaid suspension, DNR Director Mark Templeton has been reinstated by the governor.